After a wonderful couple of days house hunting with Steve and Sue, they just couldn't put the first property out of their minds. And I'm pleased to say they put in an offer which was accepted. Now, that was, well, just over a year ago. So I'm keen to find out how they're getting on. Hello.
Hello, Nikki.
I'm back.
Good to see you
back
again.
Back to see you in your new home. Lovely to see you. Sue, how are
lovely
you?
Lovely to see you, Nikki. I'm fine, thank you. Oh, you're cool. Come in.
It's lovely and toasty in here.
In that short time, they've already put their own stamp on the property.
Oh, yes, with all your possessions in. It looks great.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah, it feels just like home for us now.
And with the sun flooding in, I can remember that wonderful garden room. I actually sat in there quite happily while you two were looking around on your own, I seem to remember.
Yes, you did.
And then, of course, you've got the other conservatory at the back of the property.
Yes, we have.
Would you like to come through?
I would. I've spotted the bar as well.
Being able to create social spaces was key, and they've made the most of the entertainment features here, including the wonderful conservatory.
So how's it been since you moved in? Because I seem to remember this is the first home that you've actually bought together. You've lived together before, but this must be extra special.
Yes, it's been beautiful, hasn't it?
Yes.
We've enjoyed every minute of it.
Have you?
We're so glad that Escape to Country found us a home.
Yeah.
We wouldn't have looked at this property, so to
really?
Be property number one and be so happy here. Incredible.
The house was marketed at £450,000, £15,000 over their budget, but Steve and Sue were able to negotiate.
What did you get it for in the end?
For £435,000.
Which was your budget, top
yeah,
of your budget.
Top budget. Yes. Yeah.
From when you saw the property, which was in the summer of 2015, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. To eventually getting in, how long did the whole process take?
We got in on the 8th of December.
So it's quite a long time.
Yeah, 5-6 months. There were a few hold-ups.
But we managed to be in for Christmas, didn't
yeah,
we? Which was lovely. So we had our first Christmas in our first house together, so it was lovely. Mm.
Fabulous. Mm. And is it different having lived together but not in a home that you've jointly owned? I mean, what difference has it made?
I think it has made a difference. We always knew that we would move again, so didn't get too settled into anything in the old house.
Yeah, but this is definitely our... Yeah. Well, forever last house.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yes, we love
are.
It so much. There is no way, unless we have to move, obviously, because we're too old, we can't manage the stairs, but we would definitely be staying here, wouldn't we?
Yes.
As well as enjoying their new home, they've passionately thrown themselves into local life. After getting involved in the village's biennial Victorian Street Fair, they formed a baking group. And as community bakers, Steve and Sue are keen for a baking beginner like me to lend a hand.
Look at your apron. Stand clear man cooking. Love it. Beer, beer, beer. Oh, yes.
Right, let's see what we've got here. You're going to do the rolls.
Right, Nikki, we're going to make some
And I'm going to have a go at doing the loaf.
So how often do you get time to bake?
Oh, at least once a week.
Do you?
Yes, we do not buy any bread anymore.
That's brilliant.
Yes, it's much nicer to make your own bread.
Yes. Right. Am I doing the same as you, cutting in half?
Yeah, okay, yeah. Stretch it back. Stretch it out.
Do you share with the community or do you eat it all yourselves?
Well, at our street fair, it was all sold for charity and we sold every single loaf.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Do you find that spirit here within the village?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely. I think people have more time for you here.
Yeah.
Whereas where we lived before, obviously people have very busy lives. People are commuting, you know, it's a different sort of lifestyle here. People are much more relaxed. There's more time to spend together.
So no regrets at making the move? This is the life that you wanted, or is it more than you wanted?
More than we wanted.
Oh,
really?
Definitely.
Yeah, definitely, yeah,
yes. It's been lovely. We've thoroughly enjoyed our first 10 months here and looking forward to, well, next 10 years. Hopefully 20 or 30.
I must admit, I'm smiling here because when someone says, we didn't think you'd ever find it for us, we never would have looked at this ourselves, I think that, in a way, is the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Or the flour on the bread, I think
yes,
you should have
yes,
said
yeah,
that
yeah,
on the
yeah.
bun.
Having risen to their baking challenge, they are also keen for me to join their team at the weekly pub quiz. And it's just a short stroll from their new house.
If you're going to live in a village...
Yes, you should live in a village like this one. It's got everything you could want.
How wonderful.
two names at the top of the page, please, and we will get back to bell number one, which is general knowledge.
Hello, everyone. I'm Nikki. Thank you for letting me gate crash your team.
You're welcome.
How positive are we feeling this evening? How well are we going to do?
Well, we normally strive to come in the bottom or third from bottom.
Third from bottom?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That
would be good. Fourth from bottom where we celebrate.
Oh, okay. So that's really raising the bar then tonight. Yeah. I like that.
With the team name Scrambled Eggheads, it doesn't seem like they take it too seriously.
I'm one of the areas of expertise around the table.
Oh, music.
Music? What eras are we talking?
All of them.
All of them? Okay. Very good. Set with such conviction. I'm liking this. What else?
No, that's it.
Okay, question number one. Where on earth are you more likely to be more lighter? The poles or the equator?
Top prizes include wine and Prosecco, and it seems the whole village has turned out.
Yeah. What are we thinking, equator?
Equator.
Was that because you sweat more?
Yeah.
Fortunately for my team, the next round is music.
Pop Idol consisted of a panel of four judges: Simon Cowell, Pete Waterman, Dr. Fox, and which other famous face?
I really should know this one, as should my team.
Some of you look like you're struggling.
There's a reason I don't go to pop quizzes.
We may not have topped the scoreboard, but Sue and Steve have clearly found the winning formula for a rewarding new life in the heart of such a vibrant village.
These revisits are a wonderful opportunity to catch up with old friends. Two delightful couples with very different experiences of relocating to the country, both ending well. Each of them have found a home and a lifestyle they wouldn't change for anything. How many of us can truly say that?
If you dream of escaping to the country in England, Wales, Scotland or Northern Ireland and would also like our help, why not apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.